Hi everyone, welcome to the RPP Residence Commission. Now we will discuss a very important thing that is belongs to CSIR UGC NET. That is nothing but Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, that is one organization, and another organization is University of Grants Commission, University Grants Commission. Okay, these two organizations, that both are combinedly conducting the national eligible test that is called CSIR UGC Joint NET. Okay, so this is the belongs to like this CSIR UGC NET which having the like five types of subjects. This is different from the UGC NET that having the more than 55-60 subjects. It having the only five types of subjects. So one is chemical sciences, second one is earth and atmosphere and ocean planetary, life sciences, fourth one is mathematical sciences, fifth one is physical sciences. They are given in the like different types of questions. If chemical sciences, it having 120 questions, earth and atmosphere, ocean planetary, it gives 150 questions, life sciences is 145 questions, mathematical science 120 questions, physical science is very less number, that is 75 questions. Each type of paper having the like part A, part B, part C. Okay, so three parts are there, each paper having the three parts. Okay, now here CSIR UGC NET, it having the like two types of cadets. One is JRF and another one is LS, that is lectureship eligibility. Okay, so simply it is nothing but NET. So JRF indicates junior research fellow, NET, that is nothing but national eligibility test, that is nothing but a lectureship allowance test, lectureship like a allowing test. Now here JRF having the like a very huge amount of stipend it is provided by those two organizations. Okay, now JRF, it is eligible for the PhD all over the India, which is recognized by the CSIR labs as well as central universities, IITs, IIC Bangalore, local universities, each and every affiliated university colleges. Okay, so it is eligible for the PhD overall India, not only like any states. Okay, now here the second one is, it is eligible for the lectureship of all Indian colleges as well as assistant professor exams. Okay, so this is the advantage of JRF, junior research fellow. Now NET, which is only eligible for the lectureship. Okay, now here CSIR UGC NET, it having the like two types of classification. One is JRF and NET. So students are qualified, whoever the qualified JRF, they are having these type of facilities. NET students, NET qualified students, these type of facilities. Okay, now here age limit is there for applying those CSIR UGC NET. So JRF 28 years per unreserved category, plus SC, ST, PWD, they having the plus 5 years relaxation, and OBC students having the plus 3 years relaxation. Okay, so this is the JRF only. So NET is there is no age limit for NET. There is no age limit. Again, if you qualify the CSIR exam, if you qualify the CSIR UGC joint NET exam, so your JRF candidature will 2 years. The JRF candidature lifetime is 2 years. So NET is a lifetime. NET is overall lifetime. It is valid for the lifetime. But JRF, it is valid for the 2 years only. So this is the like a simple thing regarding to the CSIR UGC NET. Now these are the five subjects. Now, so it having the like a huge amount of stipend. So in previous case, they are announcing the like 25,000 and 28,000 for the SRF. Now here, according to the new norms and conditions, JRF is 31,000 and SRF is 35,000. Okay, not only 31 and 35. So here they are provided the house rent allowances as well as annual contingency grants. That is for annum, it is 20,000. Now HRA based on the percentage, like local cities 8%, and based on the cities like Bangalore, it is almost 12 to 16%. Okay, so based on the cities, they are given the house rent allowances for each and every students. Now this is the 8% for the local universities, like local cities, very normal cities, based on the cities. Now here JRF candidate, that is whenever your students are qualified the CSIR UGC NET, they are eligible for the JRF. So after 2 years, based on their academic research progress, so they are promoted to the SRF. They are promoted to the SRF. That is nothing but senior research fellow. So based on their progress of research work, not only any other things. Okay. So if a student can getting the senior research fellow, so he can completed the like 3 years of senior research fellowship. So the minimum stay fund year is 5 years. The minimum stay fund is 5 years. Okay, now so this is the very interesting things. Okay, now what are the eligibility conditions? What are the eligibility criteria regarding to applying of CSIR UGC NET? Now this is the like a major thing is MSc completed students or MSc final semester student. Note that point, not the final years. So final semester students of the MSc. So if they are eligible after the like result declaration time. Now in previous cases they are releasing the results very large time. I think after the completion of exam after the 3 months or 4 months they are announced. But nowadays so the exam conducted by the like CBT model, that is a computer based model. So that is conducted by the NTA. They are given the results within within a month, duration of the 1 month. That's why so it is very important MSc completed or final semester students, not only them, so integrated BSc MS or BS 4 years, BA, BTech, B forms and MSc, as well as 55% of this is the minimum criterion, 55% of their PG courses, now these courses with unreserved as well as EWS OBC category, 50% score of SC ST person with disability. So this is the score percentage of their PG courses. So these are the PG courses. Okay, so this is the eligibility criteria, these are the subjects. So these are the CSIR UGC NET backgrounds. Now here age limits, now stipends. Okay, so this is the overall idea about the CSIR UGC NET. Now we will discuss the exam pattern about CSIR UGC NET. So we are already discussed each subject, each paper having the part A, part B, part C. Part A, part B, part C. In previous case, last before exam, so they are conducting the offline mode. That means paper pen exam. That is, they are given in the OMR sheets. We will fill the correct option on OMR. We will bubble the OMR sheet. Okay. Now, last recent time, they are conducting the exam on computer based model. So, which is conducted by the NTA. Okay, National Testing Agency. Now, the exam pattern is part A, part B, part C. So now we are belongs to the chemical sciences. That's why I'll explain those exam pattern in chemical sciences particularly. Okay. Now here part A, part B, part C. So part A having the general aptitude. General aptitude. Now the part B, which is very exclusively basics of chemistry, three types of chemistry, organic, inorganic, physical. Now again, so they are given in the advanced topics in chemistry. Okay, they are given in the knowing compounds, knowing chapters, but they are given the very conceptualization of the questions. Conceptualization of the question. So now the number of questions in each category, each part. So part A is 20 questions, part B is 40 questions, part C is 60 questions. Okay. Now they are given in the 20 plus 40, 60, 60 plus 60, almost 120 questions. So not only almost all, it is a pakka. Okay. Now 20 plus 40 plus 60, that is 120 questions. Okay. Now among the 120 questions, we are maximum attended for those questions. Part A, so the maximum number of questions attempted is 15. Now part B is 35. Part C is 25. If you more than attempted those questions, in part C you are attempted 32 or 40 questions. So they are considered, so the first 25 questions only. The first 25 questions which are attempted by you. Okay. Now, so that's why you will choose the those 25 questions only. Choose the more than that. Okay. Now here 15 questions, 35 questions, 25 questions. So here 15 questions and 35 questions. Part A, part B carried by the 2 marks and part C carried by the 4 marks. Okay. So 15 twos are 30, 35 twos are 70, 25 fours are 100. The overall marks for the exam is 200 marks. The overall marks is 200 marks. Okay, now the cutoff of these exams, almost all 110 to 120, more than 120 is safe zone, more than 120. Sometimes it may be increased or sometimes it may be decreased. Last time the cutoff of CSIR net is very lesser. before last time it is more like almost all it is raised to 117. Okay, so here it is the unreserved category. Based on the reservations, the cutoff is will be lesser. Okay, like 90 to 100 and 80 to 90, 70 to 80. Those based on the belongs to the like different categories. Okay, yeah, 120, more than 120 marks is a safe zone for each and every exam. Okay, each and every time. So now here CSIR uses in that they are conducting the exam twice in a year. So now they are conducting the exam third Sunday of June and December. So they are conducting the exam two times. Now in this time they did not conduct the June exam due to the like a pandemic corona. Okay. Now let us discuss many of the students, they did a mistakes on like selecting the those questions. They are selected more than maximum attempted questions. Now I'll give the very simple reason for the attempting of exam pattern. Okay, how do you attempt the chemical science exam? Here it having the negative marks also. Okay, now here, so part A, part B is a 2-marker question, part C is 4-marker question. So each negative answer will penalized by 0.25%. So 0.25% here, 1/4 is 1 mark for negative, 0.5 mark per negative. Okay, so this is the negative. Part A, part B, part C. Okay. According to me, part C is the very score boosting part. So in part C, so many of the students, how they are attempted the question. Now I'll give the very simple trick. So part C is, so 20 among the 25 questions, 21 to 23, almost all 21 to 23 questions is maximum. Okay, don't go further more than that. If you are confirmed those questions are correct, then only you will go through the 25 questions attempt. Otherwise you will choose the 21 to 23. Okay, so if you are pucker for your concept of the those part C chemistry, then only you will go through the 25 out of 25, then only you attempt the 25 out of 25. So now basics of chemistry. So whoever that doesn't having the like a basics of chemistry, like they did not attempt at the part B questions. Every time so many of the students they are said about so part B is very difficult, they didn't difficult, but we are unfit for the solving those type of part B questions. They are given in the very basic concept of the chemistry. That's why, so I'll choose the those questions out of 20 to 25 questions is maximum. Okay, so whenever you are very brilliant in basics, then you will choose the like 35 out of 35. You can choose the 35 out of 35, so it may be possible 30 is maximum. Okay, so if you are very clever in part B, so if you are very what does it mean, if you are very brilliant in the part B, then you can attempt the more than 30 questions in part B. So now I'll take the 20 to 25 for normal students. Okay, now in case of a general aptitude, 8 to 10 questions is normal, 8 to 10 questions. Okay, now here the overall questions is mean of the questions, it may be 22. So here it may be almost all 22 or 23. So here 9 questions. Okay, now each question is 22, part C carried by the 4 marks. 22 4s are 88 marks. 22 2s are 44 marks. 9 2s are 18 marks. Okay, overall 88, 44, 18 marks. That means here 150 marks. Okay, now 150 marks, that is a very extraordinary marks. So this is the student idea. But so whenever you will came out the exam center, so you will feel it, I'm getting the 150 marks. But originally, so in, out of 22 questions, they did the mistakes of 4 questions. They did any mistake. It may be 4 mistakes, 4 wrong answers are there in part C. Like 5 to 6 wrong answers there in part B. Now here 2 to 3 wrong answers in part A. So let us assume if just four questions. Now here just let us imagine 5 questions only. Now here let us, it is 2 questions wrong only. Okay, so now here these are the negative questions. That means, so if each question carried by the 4 marks, each question negatively penalized, which wrong answer penalized by the 1 mark. That means 4 wrong answers, each question penalized by the 5 marks. 4 5s are 20 marks is left out. Then it the remaining marks is 68. Now here 5 questions, 5 2s are true, 10 marks, that is only like a carrying positive marks. But here 5 questions are negative, each wrong answer penalized by the 0.5, so overall 2.5, so pi 2.5. So almost, so let us assume here it is the 6 or 2.5, that is 6 2s are 12, 6.5s are 3, 15 marks. Okay, now here 2 questions, each question penalized by the 0.5, each wrong answer penalized by the 0.5, so the overall 2.5, 2 2.5s are 5. Okay, so the overall marks is 68, 15, 5, that is 88 marks. Okay, so definitely you lost the questions. So that's why I'm saying, what I'm saying now here, so this is the student idea, but they are getting the this type of marks. That's why you will choose the questions very perfectly. So if you perfect in your answer, then only select those questions. Otherwise, so you will stop the questions 18 to 19, doesn't matter. Okay, it doesn't matter. So if you choose the 23 questions, out of 23 you will get, you will attempted the 4 wrong answers. That will very very disappointed for your future exams. That's why, so if you are unable to solve those questions, then you will stop the questions either 18 to 19, doesn't matter. So almost 90 means 76, or 18 to 90 means 72, so 276. Now here 20 questions, that is 40, 72 plus 40, 112. Okay, now here 7 questions, it may be correct, that is 14, 104 plus 14, that is almost 120, 118 marks. That is very easier. Okay, so don't go for the 25 questions or 23 questions or 21 questions. If you are perfect in your answers, then only choose the maximum number of questions in part C. So otherwise you will choose the 18 to 19 questions or 20 questions, that is maximum for you. Okay, so don't go for the too much of questions in part C. So if you select the correct answer, very perfect answers, otherwise you do not select those questions. This is the exam pattern regarding to the CSIR and UGC. These are the exam patterns regarding to the CSIR, UGC, Giant, NEST. Exclusively it is belongs to the chemical sciences. Okay, now I'll give the syllabus copy of chemical sciences, as well as physics, earth and life science, mathematical, physical science, all the subjects syllabus, as well as official website link. Now I'll give the next video, I'll uploaded the videos on exam pattern and exam strategy, how can you prepare the CSIR exam in 2020 December. Okay, now I'll give the exam strategy, as well as reference books for the chemical sciences. Thank you so much for watching.